In today's video, I'm going to be attempting to make this little Stark Jet Chuck Glider that I made almost 2 years ago into a functional RC plane. So let's get into that.
Go in the water.
Brayden, keep it alive. Keep it alive.
Thank you. Hold up,
I'm gonna
do it
again.
Okay. Yeah.
What?
Test three. Perfect!
Number four.
No, it's number five of that.
Oh. Okay, that's number five. Test number six. Look at the plane that's surprisingly not broken yet. Test number seven. Team. What? What?
It's test number six.
It's not. It's past time.
No. We're bad at counting.
He's bad at counting.
What do you mean? You're bad at counting too.
Test number nine. We're gonna go with that.
Thought that was gonna crash early, then it did. So I didn't follow it.
I'm an expert pilot. Test number, I forgot
ten.
What number it is.
10, I think.
10? Oh, yes.
Yes.
Maybe.
He's bad at counting now.
Okay, well that's gonna about end it today.
Okay, so I fixed the plane and I decided to try to make it better on takeoffs and easier and stuff. I decided to add some landing gear onto it. It's not perfectly scaled to the plane, but I mean, I just wanted to make taking off easier. So I just have this tricycle landing gear set that I got for pretty cheap off somewhere. It has a steerable nose wheel, which is pretty nice. And then, yeah, I just fixed everything else that broke. And we're ready to test fly it again. Okay, so we're in the future now, because this is all ripped up, but you know, oh well. So what happened in that last, video, shot, is that the, oh, I guess it was on this side. The servo that was right there was too far away from the actual elevator, so then it did something like this, where the wires start bending, and that meant that the faster I went, the less elevator that I got, so then I wasn't able to, like, keep it in the air because it just wanted to go down more and more. So I fixed that for, no, I didn't. I put a better servo. So yes, I did fix that. I put a better servo on it so that it wouldn't do that. And that actually helped. So here's what happened. Okay, so that didn't work out great. I mean, it flew. It was kind of hard to control. And here's version two. It's got all of its electronics ripped out of it because I'm actually starting to work on a version 3 that'll be in the next video. It's hopefully bigger and better. Hopefully bigger and better. And, yeah. So the main problems with this is that, one, the winglets that I put on were just giving it some problems for some reason that made it not able to roll. So I ripped them off. And that actually helped a little bit. And then I actually had to rip the wheels off because they were making it too heavy to fly. So that was a problem that I kind of fixed. And then at that point, it kind of flew, but in the air, the problem slot design wasn't great for this because that. And that made problems, and the propeller hit this a lot, and it just wasn't great. So I'm going to try to do a couple of different things in the next video. So look forward to that. If you enjoyed this video, subscribe and like and comment and stuff. And I'll see you next time.
It's windy. So. My hair looks really good right now.